What's going on, guys? Cardock here. So today we're gonna be checking out a brand new game. I'm not super new, it's been out for a little while, but this is gonna be, well, first for my channel at least. Astroneer is the game. So you're an explorer. I mean, there's really not much else to it. There's no like financial system, there's no really straight line story. I don't know if that's gonna be later on down the line. As you can see, this is a pre-alpha build, so the developers are really, really committed to it. They're taking their time and actually making sure that it gets fixed whenever there's a problem. And they're adding stuff almost on a bi-weekly basis, so it's pretty nice. Yeah, we're gonna go in and check it out. I did actually, this is gonna be my second time recording it. The first playthrough, which was about like 3 hours worth of playing. I don't know what happened, but the video file got corrupted. So I already know how to pretty much play the game, which is unfortunate because I was so confused when I started. I'm just like, what do I f***ing do? But yeah, we're going to go in and start a new little guy. I'm going with the blue one because I like blue. And y'all get to join me on my little Astroneer adventure. I gotta say, the art design of this is incredibly simplistic, but at the same time, it's so well done. Like the lines are super clean, and the little triangle based like isometric shapes is just, it's really nice looking. Let's see where they got me landing. Middle of a field? I can live with this. And like I did say, I do know how to pretty much play the game. There's not a whole lot that I haven't, wrapped my head around just yet. So, I definitely don't like the fact that it is such a pain in the ass to unlock stuff without having to travel to a new planet, because I like getting everything unlocked before I start running around. But, whatever. But yeah, like I was saying at the start, there's not really a direct objective to the game. It's mostly you get to, like, terraform, and then you get to explore the world and discover new objects and research new items and all this other stuff. There's definitely a little bit of a survival risk to it. There's nothing that will directly attack you, but you definitely can get attacked by, well, I mean, there's one plant that will directly attack you. There's no creatures, there's no like hostile enemy mobs or anything like that. It's all just your like I said, there's these plants that will attack you. There's one that like explodes and shoots fucking little gas bubbles at you. There's another one that just will continuously shoot gas bubbles at you until you kill it. So yeah, it gets very, very annoying, very, very quick. All right, I think I saw some resin. Yeah, there it is. Sweet. Go ahead and start expanding our base out. I would like to take a moment to thank all of y'all, by the way. The Bloody Legend Redemption video got more views than anything else I've ever had, and I know it was only up to like 20 something views, but still, that was seriously impressive, and I really appreciate it. I'm still trying to do my best to get the video to Laser Beam's eyes, because I wanna see if he'll actually react to it. I put a lot of time and put my liver on the line for that video, so hopefully I'll get some kind of a result from it. But thank y'all for that. All right, so good thing to start out with. Get you a smelter, get you a research thing, because the researcher will open up other stuff, and sometimes it'll just crack open, and you'll get like really rare resources and stuff like that, which is always nice. And I believe, okay, so this is one of the more dangerous parts. You see that big cloud right there is getting a lot larger. That's a windstorm. Handy if it doesn't hit you directly and you have wind turbines up, because it'll charge up your entire base. Not so handy when it gets to you, because it will throw debris that will kill you on impact. So we'll wait this out. We'll be right back. All right, now that our storm has passed, there it goes, riding off in the distance, majestic as fuck. Back to work. I don't have any more resin. All right then. This would be a good time to tether up. So these little tethers here, they carry oxygen and power away from your base. They're directly linked to the base, so they'll charge up as long as the base is receiving power or has power stored. You can eventually get like batteries and stuff like that for the base, and they'll charge up and give you power throughout the night. They're very expensive though. They take a re rare resources that are not easy to come by pretty much on any planet except for the exotic one. So, but you'll see more of that later on. I keep forgetting that there are some people who have not played this game before. So, I apologize in advance if I'm kind of, yeah, well, obviously this. Yeah, I don't, that, yeah. I'm gonna shut up and keep talking now. As you can see, I've been continuously digging here for a couple of minutes, and in my battery pack, I still haven't run out of power. Oxygen is definitely a problem, as you just saw, but as long as you got two of those little solar panels on you, you're pretty much safe from running out of power while you're away from your tether lines. I don't generally build tethers out unless it's renewable resources like this, or if I'm going down into caves. You also see like there's a little node off in the distance here. I'll zoom in so you can see it. But this little node off in the distance, it produces oxygen, and if you are a little bit more of a If you're a little bit braver than I am, you can actually go out and fucking, explore on foot without using a shit ton of tethers. I don't like doing that because too many times I've wound up dead out in the middle of nowhere for my own stupidity, and that's not a fun way to live. So, yeah, dead, not a fun way to live. I really need to work on how I speak. Let's see here. More resin over here. Cool. Start collecting this before the sun goes too far down. And it doesn't matter now. I'm in the shade. That's another thing that it does take into account. If you're not in direct line of sight of the sunlight, not just above ground, but actually have to be where the sun, where you can see the sun, it won't charge your shit. So, like I said before, big kudos to the developers. They did a really good job with some of the more realistic aspects of it. Obviously, there's others that just aren't really all that realistic at all, but like I said, props where props are deserved. I'm thinking today our main focus is gonna be on getting our main base set up and getting a hold of the rover or the truck. I would prefer the truck, but I'll deal with it if it's just the rover. There you go. Give me all that oxygen. That glorious air. All right. And I don't know what we're gonna build here. Smelter's there, so I'll probably build the 3D printer here, which is gonna take aluminum or copper, excuse me. And I'm gonna need to get that means I'm just gonna need to get some copper. So. But I've got a fully charged research thing, and these are the research pods up here. Oh, I can actually just pick them off the trees. Cool, I was about to start taking that tree down. All right, let's see what we got. But yeah, after you've researched them enough, it'll stop giving you research, and it'll start giving you. Oh, nice. It'll start giving you just the resources themselves. So let's charge that sumbitch right back up. Hopefully that'll be enough. I don't think it will be. Oh, no, it'll cover it. Nice. So we can get two researches done tonight. And we'll go out and explore some more tomorrow. Hopefully bring back some more stuff. Alright. Oh, no. Why isn't it researching? Is it like just not enough power? No, it's full. Why isn't it researching? What the fuck? I seem to remember seeing power out here somewhere. There it is. Okay. Nice. Now there'll be enough power. Probably for like at least a couple of research pods. Let's see, where's another one? There we go. Bring that one back with me. Yeah, it's really wonderful how you have telekinetic powers and you can just like hover giant boulders in front of you by holding your hands in this like really, really, really creepy position. Like, it's hard to tell. Yeah, see, look at his hands. Like, what is he doing? He's like praying that the boulder doesn't fall on him or something? Anyway. Alright, so let's give that some more juice. It's like an iota worth of power that it needed. Whatever. Research my shit. Ah, see, this is what I was saying. So this one gives me coal. Now that I've researched one of those pods that looks like that, I won't get any more, like, cool stuff from it, or I won't get any more actual research from it. But what I will get is, why is it doing this again? Oh, I'm such an idiot. Because I didn't put the thing on there. Right, but that's one we haven't researched before, so yeah, it's gonna give us research. Nice. What you got? What you got? What you got? Yes! We have the truck. Alright, so now we're just gonna need to get a hold of a lot of fucking aluminum and copper. But we have the truck now, so that's huge. Alright, I think I've got enough that I can research a couple more times, so let me go find some more pods. We need to look around and find a cave. I want to find an entrance to a cave now. So, there's a mountain over there. That's usually a good direction to go in. So we'll start working our way out towards this mountain over here and see what it has to offer. Really tall oxygen fucking thing right there, but whatever. Anything else? Oh, is it the edge to a cave? That is. Holy shit, that's a deep fucking cave. Alright, well, we're gonna work with that. Start fucking excavating my way down, I suppose. Maybe I can put that actually. Like. Aha! Nice. That at least let me. Okay, it's daytime again. So that at least let me finish the little ramp I'm making. Won't allow much for. Okay. Oh, yeah, you can see like a little strip of sunlight. That's actually really fucking cool. Let's go. Huh. Oh, what did I just see? That's aluminum. Excellent. Okay, so I need more compound to get tethers to get over there. But we do have our little fucking ramp deal finished, which is nice. So now I'm just gonna go back up here and find some more compound, which shouldn't take very long. Let's see here. So far, it's so good. I'm not seeing any. Up there they are. Spoke too soon. So you see how that little orange, or that green pulsating thing over there? Yeah, it'll kill you. It'll kill you very, very efficiently and very, very quickly. Best trick for dealing with them is at a distance. And there they go. One down. And two down. Cool. Also, when they do die, they, oh, shit, missed one. Now you'll see. Ah. And the little cloud fucking follows you. Like, I understand this game is not really physics-based or logical with even the slightest semblance of logic, but come on. You gonna make the cloud of gas follow me? Like, that's cruel and unusual punishment. Alright. Yes. Give me all that delicious ore. So, I know this is laterite, but it converts over to aluminum. That was a big, like, learning point when I first started. Was figuring out that, yes, these do in fact convert over to the good stuff that you want after you've smelted them. Eh. Oh, what the fuck is going on here? Second. Ah! Come on, game. Quit being stupid. The camera controls could definitely be better. That much I will say. They could really do a lot to fix the camera control in this game. Because most of the time it makes next to no sense, but, you know. All right. Alright, we got laterite. Come on, give me one more block. Almost. There we go. Okay. I got four tethers still, and I need to get over to that copper anyway, so I'll just go ahead and use up these four tethers to... let me see here. That one. There we go. All nice and pretty. Cool. Alright, so this plant right here that I'm at, creepy looking, not dangerous unless you undercut it, it explodes when you do, and it makes that same, like, follow you around poisonous gas shit that the other ones do. I don't think these grape things do anything, except pulsate and look really fucking creepy. Oh, another problem I will say that this game does have is stuff clipping through the ground, including the player. But more importantly, because, I mean, you'll always respawn, but sometimes you find some really rare resources that, you know, can't respawn. And, like, what just fucking happened. Okay, so, if the back of your gun is, like, sitting in the ground when you get done mining something, it will, it'll clip itself through the ground and be gone for fucking ever. And it's really, really irritating. And, okay, that's all those. Alright, so now I can pick up that extra copper, because I need the copper almost as bad as I need the aluminum right now. And since this whole area is tethered off and I know where I'm going next time, I can leave behind my oxygen capsule and not waste that one little spot, because I would be able to take back all the aluminum I found and a research pod had it not been for that. So now I gotta skip out on all these nice, juicy, brand new research pods that we haven't fucked with yet, in order to get back the rest of the resources. But I'll say that I really do actually enjoy playing this game. Like it's a very relaxing game. It lets you kind of delve into your creativity and your more of your explorative side. I mean, it's not gonna be on the level of something like Minecraft or Fallout 4's settlement building or anything like that as far as creativity goes. But, you know, you can terraform to your heart's content, and I've seen some interesting designs. Obviously, there are some people who decide, you know what, penis. Just penises everywhere. But, you know, I figure that with time and with this game gaining popularity, which I really do see it doing, is especially if the devs continue working at it like they have been, I can see people doing some, like, crazy shit with it, you know, if I can, like, making people or, you know, whatever out of it. Might do that. I might just make like a little fucking statue of a person, a little homage to our brave adventurer here. Can I sprint while I'm carrying? I can. That is wonderful news. All right, but now that we got all this fucking ore, I'll be able to make that. I think you saw where I unlocked a trade platform. Trade platforms allow you to get unlimited resources, provided that you can send up unlimited resources. All these plants around us make a resource called organic. It's next to worthless, but 8 organics will net you, like, I think, either 2 or 4 of an unprocessed ore. So you can see where that can get really, really valuable really, really quick, and it's very handy on new planets to one of the first things you build, make it a trade platform, and you're almost, like, guaranteed not to ever get stuck without, you know, the ability to get fuel or ability. Actually, I don't think I did unlock the trade platform. I unlocked the fuel condenser. But it's also important because if you go onto another planet, you need to take stuff with you to make another fuel condenser. Otherwise, you know, if for whatever reason, whatever planet you're on, there's no hydrazine, then you need to make sure that you can still get the fuck off of that planet, because I've been stuck on another planet before, and it's not fun. I actually just wound up deleting the save file and starting over. So pissed off, because I had all of that recorded for y'all, and now I had to go bye-bye. I'm just like, fuck! But, yeah, whatever. Nice. Alright, we've got our printer, and we are safe now. I just need some compound. I'll start making solar panels. Some more aluminum will get me some bigger wind turbines. But I mostly want the solar panels. The solar panels are life. Oh god, it's charging so slowly. Yeah, I need to get this, the compounds next. Here, compound, compound, compound. You know what? I bet that node that I have off some direction that way, maybe? Yeah, but that node over there is mostly regenerated. Alright, so solar panel, because I need fucking energy constantly. Okay, I can't wait to start finding lithium. I need the lithium so badly. Alright, that's better. So that's the speed at which you should be recharging. And is there anything that needs copper over here? Generator, that's for the coal. We're not going to use that. There's not enough coal on this planet. So, storage. Can I fund one of those? I cannot. Shit. Alright. There's got to be more compound around here somewhere. Somewhat relatively close by. Now, I'm an American, so I definitely need my instant gratification filled. Otherwise, I'm just going to be a blithering mess of unhappiness. Tell you what, if I can get 10 likes on the video, I'll upload something. I'll upload a nice long, you know, redneck fucking tirade on how I think the country should be run, and y'all can all just sit there and crucify me on the fucking stand of YouTube. But yeah, 10 likes and I'll bitch about the way the world should be and how it actually is. So I don't really much need copper right now. I need aluminum. It's unfortunate because I've got plenty of copper everywhere. Ugh, it's so fucking creepy sounding. More copper. Okay, that's a problem. Eh. Shit. Where the fuck's all the aluminum? I'm seeing, like, multitudes of copper, but no aluminum. What am I missing? There's gotta be some around here. I have a hard time believing that that was the only aluminum deposit in this whole damn cave system. It's a pretty big ass fucking cave system. What do we got? Come on. Come on. Talk to me, caves. Talk to me. What you got for me? I'm about to do something I don't normally do, and that's why I'm collecting all this extra fucking oxygen and power. I'm gonna venture away from my tether lines and hopefully be able to keep track of where I'm at while I do so. But I gotta get some aluminum, because it's gonna be a really wasted trip to come down here and go back with nothing but copper. This copper's not gonna do me any fucking good right now. I'm not gonna be able to get my truck until I get some aluminum. And there's so fucking much copper, too! I heard a farter. Oh, that's over there, okay. We got down here. Is that a drop off? It looks to be a very, very large drop off, actually. Is there any aluminum down in there? Yes, there is. Thick! Even with extra oxygen and copper, I don't know how the fuck I'm gonna get over there. Well, there went my backup tank. I don't know. Because I don't have the. Oh! Haha! Every so often you get lucky. Now I can make more tethers. Yeah, I know, I'm running low on oxygen, you gotta tell me. Alright, so now I just need to get back to my tether lines, which I think we're this way. Oh god, I'm really close to fart clouds, that's not good. DC's bad. Ah, fuck, there's aluminum there. Where's my tethers? Shit, that ain't good. See, this is why I don't like leaving my tether lines. Okay, so there's some aluminum right around the corner from the tether lines, nice. Crisis averted. Onward to the good stuff. Alright, let's see here. Ow, fuck. Yeah, see, they hurt you when you kill them. Alright, so let's see what we got here. Trade platform. Alright, so I'm pretty much set now. I don't have to ever worry about getting any more resources. Ever again. Because now I can just trade for whatever I want. And with all that fucking copper down there, I can actually get some pretty solid amounts of stuff. Alright, we're going to take all that aluminum down some more. Go ahead, smelt all that shit down. I'm going to need some more compound, but should be easy enough to get a hold of. I'm just going to have to charge up. What's it doing? Wind power right now? Yeah. Alright, so since I've got enough coming through, I'll go ahead and make a bigger wind turbine. I'm going to have the extra, I'll have the extra aluminum, so it's not that big of a deal. But I need power more than I need anything else. Oh, shit, I've got a shit ton of compound sitting right here. Nice. Alright, you go over here and start generating me some power. Did my smelter get enough? Yes, it did. Excellent, 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 excellent. Now, provided I have enough power with the vehicle bay, I'll have the truck running right now for all y'all. Alright. Come on, win. Don't let me down. Right. And voila! We have a tro, God. Right. That's going to be a problem. Oh, never mind. It won't be, I guess. It's a really, really good... good arm there, thing, but, alright. At least since it has a seat now, I can just tab to flip it over, but, alright. There we go. So we have a very oddly parked truck now. Nice. Alright guys, so that's going to do it for me. We'll have another episode up sooner than later. I'm probably going to try and make this into a series. I'll be trying to drop videos at least every couple of days for this one. I really do enjoy this game. I'm hoping y'all are liking it too. If you have any suggestions or maybe I missed something or you saw something that I need to know about, let me know. But yeah, hope y'all enjoyed it. And please leave a like, comment, subscribe, do whatever, share it with your friends, share it with your enemies. I don't really care. I'll catch y'all on the next one. Bye-bye.